Guys, did you hear? There's 4 new elements! Dang it, now I'm gonna have to change my shower curtain. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. This week, the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry announced that 4 new elements will be joining the other 114 on the periodic table of elements. The addition of elements 113, 115, 117, and 118 means the 7th row or period is now complete. They still don't have proper names yet, they're just called by their numbers. So where did these as yet unnamed elements come from? Scientists from Lawrence Livermore Laboratory in California and the Riken Institute in Japan smashed atoms together in particle accelerators. And these new elements were created when the 2 nuclei fused. The new elements existed only for a fraction of a second. Then they decayed into isotopes of other elements. Element 113, the one created in Japan, exists for less than 1/1000th of a second before it decays into other isotopes. So it's unlikely you'll run into this element anytime soon. So all right, sweet, new elements. While cool, it probably won't mean much for your daily life. Yet. Unless you have to memorize the entire table in chemistry class. Sorry, 10th graders. But for science, it could be huge. Scientists have been searching for the elusive island of stability, which according to a theory by Nobel laureate Glenn Seaborg, is a stable element with just the right number of protons and neutrons. And these new elements might be getting scientists closer to the island of stability. You see, most heavy elements, ones with more than 113 protons like these new ones, only exist for a short amount of time. That's because the force of the positive charges of their protons is too strong, and the nucleus is pushed and pulled apart in a fraction of a second. But just like atoms become stable when their outer electron shells are full, some researchers like Seaborg believe that if a nuclei has a certain number of protons, arranged in just the right way, the element would be stable, it could last. If we can create this theoretical stable element, it could be used to build things we haven't even imagined yet. Even the effort of doing so teaches scientists a tremendous amount of just basic nuclear physics. According to Seaborg, the magic number to hit is 114 protons and 184 neutrons. And after 30 years of trying, Seaborg's mentee Ken Moody finally hit the sweet spot by slamming together plutonium and calcium, which briefly created a new element. Unfortunately, while the element now called flerovium, or FL, has 114 protons, it doesn't have the needed 184 neutrons, and so it fell apart too quickly. Element 117 has been heralded as a possible shore to the island of stability. A US-Russian team first created it at the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research. Described in the journal Physical Review Letters, this new element has a half-life of about 50,000ths of a second, which means in that short of a time, half the element will decay into other isotopes, like lawrencium-266, which had 103 protons and 163 neutrons, a combination never seen before. This lawrencium-266 even lasted a long time for an isotope, with a half-life of 11 hours. Because of this, one of the lead authors said, "Perhaps we are at the shore of the island of stability." So maybe science is one step closer to creating a new element which we could use in ways we haven't even dreamed of. There's no theoretical limit to how big elements can get. One day scientists might just start filling out the elusive 8th row. So don't change your shower curtain just yet. So what happens now with these new elements? What happens when new elements are added to the periodic table? There is trial and error in science constantly, but what did it really take to perfect the gold standard tool that hangs in every chemistry classroom? To find out, Trace is the answer over on Test 2 Plus.
The periodic table that we use today is a list of elements, but it's actually more than just a list of elements. It's not even really a table. It's actually a tool. It's like a mnemonic to understand how all the elements fit together and what they all can do.
Do you have a favorite element? Tell us what and why down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.